It is a methane. Now, let us apply our moment of inertia on this molecule. Okay. Now, through this axis or through this molecule, let us assume that x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. Okay. Now, let us, what happened to x-axis? Through this, if it is. Now, either plane or axis, either plane or axis. What happens? Through this, it has moment of inertia, that is IA. Let us moment of inertia. Through this axis, if I am rotating the molecule like this, through this axis, what happens? This is IA. What it is? IA. Through this axis, I am rotating. What it is? IA. Okay. Now, let us go to IB through this axis. Now, this is IB. You see that? What it is? IB. This is IB. Moment of inertia in y direction. Moment of inertia in y direction. And this is
z axis.
IC. Let us, IC is this one. This is IC. Moment of inertia in this direction. IC. Now, let us compare this IA, IB, and IC. All are equal. Okay? All are equal.
Equal.
IA equal to IB equal to
IC. IB equal to IC.
So now, what is the spherical molecule? Okay? What type of molecule it is? Spherical. What is the requirement for spherical? Moment of inertia in x-axis, moment of inertia in y-axis,
zero.
Moment of inertia in z-axis. Okay, three things same. IA equal to IB equal to IC. This is a water molecule. How it will be? Now let us, through this x-axis, through y-axis, through z-axis. If I am rotating this IC, if I am rotating this, this is IB. IB. And if I am rotating like this, see that IA is different from IB and IC. They are not at all equal. Because you see, the molecule itself will tell us, if you are rotating the through x-axis, if you are rotating, what will happen? These two atoms are on the not on the same axis. Only oxygen is there on the axis. Hydrogens are not on the same axis. This, like this, if you are rotating, what happens? If you are rotating this, this is an axis which you are rotating the molecule like this, okay? This is the one IA, and if you come to the IB and IC, this is IB and this is IC. IB, if you are like this, it is. You see that this is the IB, okay? This is IB and this IC, just let us, this is IC. This is IC. IA equal to IB equal to IC is not correct with respect to water molecule. With respect to water molecule, IA is not equal to IB is not equal to IC. IA, IB, IC all are different with respect to water molecule. Not only water, if you are replacing this with anything, just like phenol, phenol, what will be there with respect to this phenol? This is oxygen and hydrogen, let us. Here, what will be there? One benzene ring will be there. Here, one benzene ring. Let us assume this is a benzene, and this is a O, and this is H. Phenol, what it is? Phenol. Phenol molecule. Benzene ring, aromatic O and H. Even H2O2 will be coming under same thing. H2O2. Let us do one small modification in this. What I do, instead of one hydrogen, I will replace the hydrogen atom with chlorine, methyl chloride. Now, whether this molecule is spherical, please tell me. Whether is it spherical now? No, it is not spherical. Because IZ, through this axis, IA will be IB. That is not a problem. With respect to Z axis, we have replaced the hydrogen atom with chlorine or fluorine. So now it is not spherical molecule. Okay? It is not a spherical molecule. That means IA, IB, IC is not equal for this molecule. Okay? This is the one type. I will show you the two at a time. This is oblate actually. This is oblate because the density of the mass and the radius of this molecule, mass and R, you see that Z-axis we are having less. Z-axis we are having less moment of inertia. That means Z-axis we are reducing. Let us assume this is a BCl3. BCl3 is an sp3 sp2 hybridized molecule. What will happen? Ia will be ic, ia equal to ib, but ic is very less. Okay, this is the oblate. You see that now this is methyl fluoride. Methyl fluoride is different from methane because what happens? The moment of inertia of this methane and the moment of inertia of this methyl fluoride in z axis it will differ. This is a spherical molecule. This is a spherical molecule, but this is not a spherical molecule. You keep in mind. Okay, I think now we have visualized the molecule and now it is easy. You can classify the molecule based on this concept. Okay, linear molecules we know well now, spherical molecules we know well, and prolate molecule and oblate molecule. Let us this is oblate. A B equal, C will not be. Okay, here this is boron trichloride. Okay, the black one is boron atom and this one is chlorine. Let us take x-axis. Through this axis, if I am rotating the molecule like this, okay, okay, this is the IA. Okay, have you understand now? IA.
Yes, sir.
Now, if I am rotating the molecule through the y-axis like this, this is IB.
IB.
This is IB. Now, let us rotate the molecule in z-axis. What it is? IC. IA is different from?
IB.
IB is different from IC. IC is this one. You see that? Okay. This is about oblate molecule. And methyl fluoride and chloroform. Okay. Prolate molecules. Let us go to this one more molecule. Yes. Ammonia. Oblate only. Okay. But already the molecule is in Z axis, no atoms.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is oblate. If suppose iodomethane is there, let us iodomethane, same molecule. Let us assume this is iodomethane. Now what will happen? IC will be higher because iodine atomic weight is high. Atomic weight of the iodine is very high. Atomic weight of iodine is very high. Atomic weight of the iodine is very high. That's what this will be coming under a prolate molecule. Okay, so because so like this, it will be molecule will be like this. Okay, is a prolate and oblate molecule. Okay.